this is Honda's new CBR300. Replaces the old 250. It's got an extra 35cc, 285, and an extra 3 horsepower. We're testing it for MCN today. Tim's just getting the still photography for that. And we're having a bit of a go around the Cambridgeshire and Bedfordshire roads to see what we think to it. On the 300R compared to the old 250, well, most importantly is the engine. It's got an extra 36cc, which doesn't sound like a staggering amount if you're looking at a 600 or a 1000, but it's quite a percentage difference on a 250. It brings another 3 horsepower and quite a lot of extra torque. I've not ridden the 250 that comes before, but this gives enough power to have a good road ride. You can overtake traffic at 60 to 70 miles an hour, and you don't feel like you're riding around on a slow bike. It's not like riding a 125. This rides along at a perfectly credible speed, and you will still be faster than the vast majority of cars on the road. Also new is the CBR look. They've introduced a twin headlight at the front, which carries on the look from the rest of the CBR range, whereas the old 250R had a single headlight. I think the looks are much more dramatic than they were before. It looks like a mini CBR 500 or 600 or even a Fireblade. I think it looks credible, and I don't think you're going to find that people are looking down the nose at you on one of these. The brakes, ABS are standard. I think that's really, really crucial for the sort of market that this bike is aimed at. I think as a new rider, ABS is a brilliant benefit. Especially important on this bike because the standard tyres are RIC road winners, and to be perfectly frank, they're pretty hopeless. It's not so bad on this bike as it is on others because of the ABS. You know you can't get yourself into such braking issues. The tyres are something I'd be looking to replace really early on. Well, we've had the CBR300R for the day now. I'm quite taken with this little bike. It's not perfect. The tyres aren't the best, and the braking isn't tip-top like a modern 600cc sports bike. But as a whole package, everything hangs together really well, and it's been damn good fun. If I was on an A2 licence, this would be right up my street. And as a more experienced rider, I've had a whole load of fun. It's made me wonder why more of us don't buy something like this, or why manufacturers don't bring something out that's a little bit less powered for more experienced riders, because you can really ride one of these. I'm going to take it for the weekend, and I think, do you know what, I think it's going to be a really good fun weekend.